Fox News is America's election headquarters, and there's a new study from the Pew Research Center suggesting that young voters are moving away from the Democratic Party. According to the study, fewer 18 to 29-year-olds call themselves Democrats today than in 2008, the year young voters came out in record numbers to help vote President Barack Obama into office. So what's the reason for the dip in young Democrats, and how could this affect the upcoming elections? Joining me now to debate this, conservative Evan Gassen, who is a program officer of the Young Americas Foundation, and Democratic strategist Sam Bennett, who is president of the Women's Campaign Forum. Good to see both. Sam, let me start with you.
Sure.
College students were a real force 2 years ago. What happened?
Absolutely. Well, let's be honest, it's only a 5% dip. It went from 62% to 57%. And the truth of the matter is, young people overwhelmingly still identify themselves, Greg, with social values that could only be described as progressive. Overwhelmingly, they're in support of, for example, gay marriage. So I think what we're seeing here is admittedly probably the effect of the economy. The economy has probably affected these young people more than most. And just the fact that they're not self-identifying as Democrats doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to change their patterns once it comes to vote for a president. So I think this is a situation where we're probably going to see still a very strong turnout in the election of these young people voting President Barack Obama back in.
You know, Evan, maybe it's something else. Maybe students are liberal until they sort of graduate and join the real world, and they get a job, and they work really hard, and they open their paycheck, and they invariably they say, wow, what happened? Maybe it's that dynamic that's beginning to change their views.
That dynamic has a lot to do with it. Listen, youth unemployment is 19.1% right now. The only thing on the youth's mind right now, millennials' minds, is jobs. I don't have a job, and the Republicans are offering solutions to that problem, whereas the stimulus program didn't work.
You know, Sam, 2 years ago, Barack Obama had a 66% edge among young people compared to 32% for John McCain. But here's what a young student leader is quoted as saying in a recent article at Colorado State University. People are angry. They're angry about the budget deficit, health care plan, angry about this and that. I feel like Republicans definitely, definitely have a chance of getting back on their feet. Is there a palpable apathy, if not anger, among young people?
Oh, I think there's an anger across the board in the electorate. We've seen that with the rise of the Tea Party. But bottom line, when it comes to election time, what's going to be critical for Barack or any candidate is, do they appeal to the young? Barack did an exceptional job of appealing on the basis of change. Remember, that was the call word of his campaign. So I think it's going to boil down to a lot of sex and sizzle, showmanship, in addition to substance, going to really determine what the young people do in the upcoming election.
Well, you know, Evan, maybe there is a realization that among young people, that they're going to be saddled with an enormous debt that didn't exist 2 years ago. And they're going to have to pay through taxes for the actions of their parents and their predecessors.
If you think millennials are disillusioned with the Democratic Party right now, just wait until the cost of Obamacare gets put into this conversation. Look, we've had 4 years of a Reid-Pelosi Congress, and we've seen youth unemployment get raised by 10%. That's a huge uptick. An empty suit standing in front of a teleprompter who admittedly reads that teleprompter very well is not going to get the youth vote this year. It's just not going to happen.
Sam, what do
you
think?
Well, I got to tell you, as a Democratic Party chair back in my neck of the woods, I had to do all the party rallies, including some of the Republican ones. And Obama was no empty suit, with all due respect. He stood up. He electrified the crowd. He got everyone excited. Obama is not an empty suit. And let's be honest, some of the debt that we're inheriting came from a previous administration. But what's really important, who has the message that's going to re-electrify the country and demonstrate that we are making progress and we are moving forward? That's
Sam,
what's going to sell.
Sam Bennett, Evan Gassman, good to see you both. Thank you
good
so much for being with us.
Thank you so much.